Morning, girls. We are in continuation of our chapter number 2 in maths, and now today we will study about the properties of operations on whole numbers. Operations, what are operations? They are addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So we will study about the properties of those operations. Today we will study about the properties of addition and subtraction. Okay. So the first property we come to is closure property. What does this property mean? This property means that if A is a whole number and B is also a whole number, then addition of these two, if it comes a whole number only, that means this property holds true for addition. That means if A is a whole number, B is a whole number, two whole numbers are there, and if they are added and the result that you get after the addition is also a whole number, it is also belonging in the same set, that means this closure property is true for addition, because after adding two whole numbers we are getting a whole number only. Okay, for example, 5 plus 3, 5 is also a whole number, 3 is also a whole number, we get 8. 8 is also a whole number. So that means this holds true for addition. You can take any other example. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 is also a whole number. 17 plus 5, 22. It is also a whole number. Okay. Now we come to subtraction. We are doing both the operations side by side. We are taking one property and we will see whether this property holds true for addition, and we will see whether this property holds true for subtraction. Both addition and subtraction we are doing together. Okay, now let's come to the subtraction. Now after this, it is subtraction. The same property, closure property. Okay, A minus B. Suppose A is a whole number, B is also a whole number. Do we always get a whole number? Let's see. Suppose A is 5 and B is 2. 5 minus 2 will give you 3. That means 3 is also a whole number. 5 is a whole number, 2 is a whole number, and the subtraction is giving you a whole number. Okay. But what in this case? Suppose A is 1 and B is 3. 1 minus 3, what does it give? It gives minus 2. Minus 2 is not a whole number. It does not belong to the set of whole numbers. Okay. So what happens? We will say that it does not hold true for subtraction when A is smaller than B. When A is greater than B, then it holds true. First number is greater than the next number, 5 minus 2, then it holds true. But when A becomes smaller than B, then it does not hold true for subtraction. Okay. Now the second property we come to is commutative property. What does commutative property means? It means that if A and B are two whole numbers, then A plus B is equal to B plus A. That means we are just changing the position of the whole numbers. Okay, let us see whether this is true for addition or not. Let's do one operation of addition. Let's take two whole numbers. Let us say A is 2 and B is 3. 2 plus 3, what does it give? 5. On the other side, now we are changing the positions. So here B plus A, B is 3, you know that, and plus 2. 3 plus 2 also gives you 5. So that means left hand side is equal to right hand side. Okay, so that means this property, commutative property, holds true for addition. If we add two numbers, any two whole numbers, then, and if we change the position of them, okay, then also their result is same in addition. Now let's see what happens in subtraction. Let us say, that means according to commutative property, A minus B should be equal to B minus A. Okay, let's see whether it is true or not. Let's take A is equal to 3 and B is equal to 2. So 3 minus 2, what does it give? 1. Is it equal to, now B minus A, B is 2 and A is 3. 2 minus 3 gives you minus 1. Isn't it? So here, what is happening? A minus B is not equal to
b minus a is not equal to. Okay, that means this property does not hold true for subtraction. Is that clear? Girls, this is for your understanding. How to write the properties before you start this exercise, I will tick mark in the book and from there you will copy it. Now girls, we come to the third property, which is the associative property. Okay, associative property means that if there are three whole numbers A, B, C, okay, and we put first two whole numbers in the bracket, A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. And now we have put brackets, these two B and C in the bracket. That means we have changed the position of the brackets. In commutative property, what we were doing, we were changing the position of the whole numbers. Here we are not changing the position of the whole numbers. In associative property, we just change the position of the brackets. Okay. And you know that the, which are whatever whole numbers are there in the bracket, we have to do that operation first. So let's check whether it is true for addition or not. Let us say that A is 2, B is 3 and C is 4. Let us take these numbers. Okay, so it says that 2 plus 3 in the bracket plus 4 should be equal to 2 plus 3 plus 4. 3 plus 4, now they are in the bracket. Let's solve them. 2 plus 3 gives you 5. 5 and 4 gives you 9. Okay, 9. Left hand side comes to 9. Now the right hand side. 2 plus, now 3 plus 4 has to be done first because it is in the bracket. 3 plus 4 gives you 7. 2 plus 7 gives you 9. So that means left hand side is coming equal to right hand side. So that means this property holds true for addition. Clear? Now let's take in the subtraction. Let's check whether this property is true in subtraction also or not. Here we have taken A is equal to 6, B is equal to 4 and C is equal to 2. Right? So now 6 minus 4, this is a subtraction. So everywhere the sign of minus has come. Okay? So 6 minus 4 minus 2, these two in the bracket, is it equal to 6 minus 4 minus 2? Now these two in the bracket. Let's solve them. 6 minus 4 gives you 2. So 2 minus 2. This is the left hand side. Now we come to the right hand side now. 6 minus, now this has to be solved first. 4 minus 2 gives you 2. 6 minus 2. Clear? So what comes on the left hand side? 2 minus 2 gives you 0. And here 6 minus 2 gives you 4. So they are not equal. Right? They are not equal. So that means this property does not hold true for subtraction. Now girls, we come to the fourth property, that is a property of 0. What does this property mean? It means that if 0 is added to any whole number, it should give the whole number itself. Or if 0 is subtracted from any whole number, it should give the whole number itself. Let's see whether it holds true for addition and subtraction. Okay, so that means A plus 0 should be equal to A. Let us take the value of A to be 2. 2 plus 0 gives 2. That means it is giving the same whole number. Okay, so this property holds true for addition. And that's why 0 is also called identity element. Why identity element? Why? Because it is giving the same whole number to which it is being added. Identity. It is giving the same identical whole number. Okay. Now, let's see whether it holds true for subtraction or not. A minus 0 should give A only. Let's take the value of A to be 2. 2 minus 0 gives you 2. So, this property holds true for subtraction also. Okay. So, now let's do the exercise. Second B, and then it will be more clear to you. Okay, now we come to the exercise second B, and we'll do the first question. In first question, we will do first, third, fourth and fifth part. Okay, in the classwork copy. So what is the first question? We have to fill this blank so that this statement becomes true. Okay, that means this left hand side should become equal to this right hand side. Okay, so the first question is 529 plus dash should be equal to 398 plus 529. So here you can see that there is 529 here, 529 here. Okay. So which other digit is missing this side? 398. Okay. So 529 plus 398 will become equal to 398 plus 529. We have simply changed the position of the digit of these numbers. Okay. And which property is this? Then we change the position of the numbers only. That is commutative property. So here it will come 398. Okay. Now the third part. 10,000 plus dash should be equal to 10,000. Anything added to 10,000 should give 10,000 only. What is that number? That is 0 only. Isn't it? Because if we add 1, it will give 10,001. 2, it will give 10,002. Only 0. On adding 0, we will get the same number. Same whole number. Okay. So, 0 is the answer. And which property is this? This is the property of 0. We just did it. Now, the fourth part. Fourth part says 12 plus 47 plus 88 should be equal to 100 plus dash. Now, here girls, this is 100 here. Now, which two digits make 100 here? 88 plus 12 will give you 100. Okay. So, these two are taken care of. 100 has come here. Which digit is left? Only 47. So, we'll do 47. We'll write 47 here. Is that clear? Now, the fifth part. Fifth part says 39 plus 201 plus 18. These two have come in the bracket now. Should be equal to 39 plus 201. Now, these two digits have come in the bracket. Which digit is left? 18 is left. So, 18 will come here. And which property is this? This is associative property, where the position of the bracket is getting changed. Clear? Okay. Here, we just have to do the fill in the blanks. We don't have to mention the property. I'm explaining you so that you can understand. Now, we come to the second question. Second question says that you have to find the sum. In the first part, it is 217 plus 483. It gives you 700. Second part, 483 plus 217. They have just changed the position of these numbers. It gives 700. Are they same? Yes, they are same. You will write it. Yes, they are same. And which property of addition do they show? When we change the position of the numbers, which is that property? Commutative. They show commutative property of addition. Clear? Okay, girls, now we come to the third question. Third question says that you have to add these first and the second part, and then you have to compare the result. So first part is 39,208 plus 392. These two are in brackets, so we have to add these first. The answer is 39,600 plus 726 gives you 40,326. Second part says 39,208 plus 392 plus 726. These two have to be added first. So we have added them, and the answer is 40,326. Is this same as this? Yes. So yes, they are equal. And which property are they showing? There is a change of the bracket. Okay. So they show associative property of addition. Now we come to the fourth question. Fourth question, they have said that 5 plus 24 plus 25 plus 6 is equal to 5 plus 25 plus 24 plus 6. Which property does it show? Now here, girls, there is no bracket. Okay. Only you can see that 24 and 25, their positions are getting changed. They have written 25 first and 24 later. Right? So which property is this? Commutative property. Fifth question, 18 plus 82 plus 8, this in bracket, is equal to 18 plus 82. Now these two have come in the bracket, plus 8. So which property is this? This is associative property. Okay, with this we come to an end of this exercise 2B.